What's poppin' YouTube? Welcome back to another video. If it's your first time on this channel and you enjoy this video, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for future content. Today was FunCon. We actually went to Funko Hollywood and we also got selected for the lottery. Let's go ahead and get this one started.
We are at Hollywood for FunCon 2021.
So just like the grand opening, they actually have the registration area in this parking lot. And there's quite a lot of people already.
So here we are in the 10 a.m. line, and right next to me on the side is the 11 a.m. And we are almost in. It sounds like they're having a pretty cool party inside the tent, so it sounds pretty exciting. Let's see what's going on there. I can't wait for this Freddy soda. And then we also got this cool poster today.
You guys are the first. Pat your tails on the back. You guys are the first.
Got a little lump behind that. Mystery prize.
No! No! Come on, come on, come on. Let's do bocce rules. If you not get in, you get it.
There's 104 days of summer vacation. The school comes along just to end it. So the annual problem for our generation is finding a good way to spend it.
Alright, we need some help from the audience here.
We need some fire.
Give you a special prize. Bring him out a gigantic Frodo.
Yeah!
Wow. Open it! Open it! What is it? Oh my goodness! Oh my gosh, I wish that was mine. He wants to pass it on and give it to one of you. In the true spirit of FunCon. Anybody who has a Mad Hatter Blacklight t-shirt on, raise your hand. Right there.
And I almost wore this shirt today.
So you're in, and now we're just waiting to head over to the table and see what exclusives they have. So here's what they have. Unfortunately, they do not have everything that was online, but they have some cool stuff still. So they have Rocketeer, they have the Blacklight White Rabbit, they have Smaxy the Seal, and then a surprise Jack. So this is how Funko lottery systems work. Once you put in the password, you'll see everything that is available, and whatever you want, add to the cart. And then you guys have to be really, really quick because stuff sell out really quick. So you guys can see I was actually pretty slow today. Not like myself, but I was at Funko Hollywood and in line. It was hot and I had to pay attention there and on my phone. So it was really hard for me, but it was crazy because today I was actually not supposed to be at Funko Hollywood. My original registration date was for tomorrow at 10 a.m., but somehow my ticket said for today at 10 a.m., so I had to go today, and it did affect me for my lottery, so you guys could see whatever I am going to get really shortly. I did miss out on quite a few things in the end that I did want for myself, but overall, I still walked away with some things, but check it out. So we missed out on Galactus. It's sold out, and of course, one sells out, another sells out. We got our first Soda figure selling out, which was Webster. And then it really sucks when stuff sell out, they just continuously sell out. We missed out on Harley Quinn as well. And then now we're just waiting and waiting for the cart to update. And we're trying to get to checkout. Prince Adam sold out and we're still trying to get to checkout. And what happens next? Two that I really wanted sold out, Snow White and the Russo brothers. those two missed out on. We're getting there. We're getting there. Nope. We missed out on another one. So can we get there? Orders being processed. And finally, we made it through. This is everything that I ended up with. Not too bad, but I did miss out on a few things I wanted.
So for FunCon, Funko actually had a virtual fun days available, and this was also based off of a lottery system. I was selected, and for this, you actually had to pick one team out of four, and I went ahead and chose the Fnatic Fury team, and this team was the only one to sell out during the lottery. The next day, they had all three available for the public, and with some help, I actually got my hands on all the other three teams, so we're gonna go and take a closer look. So as you guys already saw, whenever you purchase this box, one of the items you get is the pin for the team you chose. And then you also get these Bam Bams. I don't know what exactly it is. I don't think I'm gonna open it up just because it doesn't look like something I'll care about. But you also get a bandana for the team you chose. Let's go ahead and open one up at least. So here it is. We have the bandana for the Funko Fnatic Fury team. That looks pretty cool, so that's really nice. So at the price point of $100, a lot of people did pass on these Fun Days boxes once they got selected for the lottery. I personally thought it was really worth it because you get that one pop of the mascot for your team. Then you get some other extra goodies, such as this awesome Torchy Funko Pop. Now on the back of this pop, it says, four teams converge on Funko Stadium to participate in the most eagerly anticipated event of the year, the Fun Days Games. Great feats of agility and strength determine which team will be crowned the victor. Competitors face several challenges, each a chance at winning a medal for their team. When the final challenge ends, the total medal count will determine which team stands atop the victory podium. Go for the gold. Let the Fun Days games begin. So we have four different teams. They all compete against each other, but I'm wondering how this is all going to work out. I think they have something set up virtually, but I don't know what they have planned. In this box, we also had an awesome two-pack. A lot of people didn't like this, but I personally love it. We have the CEO and the founder of Funko, Brian Mariotti and Mike Becker. So this is a really cool two-pack, and we saw Mike Becker today at Funko Hollywood. He seems like a really cool guy, really entertaining, and honestly, I'm glad to have this one in my collection. And then we have one final item, which is this pop podium. Pretty cool. I think they put this up on Funko site for like $15. But it wasn't the same color. So this one's black. I think the one they had for sale was either blue or white. I don't remember, but looks pretty neat. You can use it to rank your pops. So here we have all four team pins, and it's time to get a closer look at the Funko Pops. I almost forgot to share all the bandanas. So there is the one for Funko Force. And then over here, we have the Proto Punks. I think this one might be the coolest looking one for the bandanas. And then we have Pop Rangers, probably my least favorite. And then the Fnatic Fury once again. So why don't we start off with the team I chose originally, the Fnatic Fury box. So I'm not sure if these are all in the same boxes or not, but this is what it looks like. It says Fun Days Games. And then on the back, you can see all four of the pops. And then inside we have the pops. So let's go ahead and open this up and see what it looks like. Hopefully it's nice in here because this box is pretty fragile from what it looks like. So let's try to get it out as gently as possible and see if we can keep this box in good condition too. So, all right, we have it opened up. I like this. This is a cool design actually. And then we have to just press it up. I suck at keeping these in good condition, honestly. Yep. See, I already ripped it. It's not a big deal. We have what, three more of them? So it doesn't matter. I'm not really gonna keep this. I don't think so. I just care about the pops. All right, so we have the Fnatic Fury Tornado Pop in here, guys. It looks amazing. I can't wait to see this one. It's like really tight in there, but nice. It arrived in good condition. This looks fantastic. Limited edition of 5,000 pieces. I think they're all limited edition of 5,000 pieces, but this one, like I said, is the one that sold out first. So to save us some time, I already got the rest of the pops out. Here's the Proto Punks. Definitely a really cool one. And I do not regret getting this one because like I said earlier, this one was the one I was really having a hard time deciding between this or Fnatic Furies because I thought this one looks really cool. Plus, I really love the colors black and pink together. It looks amazing. This pop looks great. And then based off of sellout, this was the second most popular team after Fnatic Fury. It was Funko Force. This is a really cool looking figure. I do like that it's metallic. I still think Proto Punks looks better. I don't know what it is about that pop. I just really, really like it. But this is definitely the third best in my opinion. And then finally, we're down to the last team, the least wanted of them all. It was the Pop Rangers. Now, what would be really funny is if this ends up being the winner at the end, which I could see happening. Now, personally, I do think it's a cool figure, but I must admit that it is definitely my least favorite of them all. But you know what? It's a cool design. I like all four of these. If you guys got any of the Fun Days boxes, let me know which team you guys chose. And I'm super excited for the last box that we'll be receiving, which has three Freddy Funkos. That's what makes this box so worth the $100. All right, guys, so now it's time to share our haul from FunCon at Funko Hollywood. So they did not have too many of the exclusives, but we did get some cool stuff. So here we have Smaxy the Seal. So this is an old school ad icon. I don't actually remember this serial, but it does look really cool. And just by looking at the back of the box, you could tell it is a really old serial, so I like this pop. Let's go ahead and see what we have next. So this one is one that I was super excited about. We have the Rocketeer. Now this is a really cool looking Funko Pop, and we did get that Funko Soda for the soda collection. So this will look really nice next to that. So the cool thing about being in the tent today, they actually gave out some free stuff. So we got some cool little stickers. We got Fun TV over there. And then I think we have another sticker in here. I don't know where it went. Oh, here it is. FunCon. And then they gave us this mystery mini of Deadpool. I actually have never opened one of these before for Deadpool. So you know what? Let's see what we have inside. It'll be cool if we get something rare. All right. I can't get this open, guys. Bear with me. Bear with me. All right. There you go. I'm more of a Funko Soda guy, but you know what? Let's see what we could pull. So here are the ratios on the other side. And let's go ahead and open it up. This is fun. It was free, so it's a cool little gift they gave me. I did not get selected to play any of the games today, which was unfortunate because it looked really fun. And a lot of people walked home with prototypes. I don't have any prototypes, so that would have been exciting. So, all right, what do we have in here? It looks like, is that the Dino Pool? Huh. If it is, that's pretty cool, guys. I know it's a 1 out of 6, but Dino Pool? Is it? Yeah, nice. That's pretty cool. I like it, actually. And then we also got a pin in here, guys. It's pretty cool. Check it out. Fun TV. Unfortunately, I did not get that Funko Soda pin I saw some people get. That was really cool, but at least we got something nice. All right, let's go to see what else we have in here, guys. So we've got... This one's exciting. This is one that I was really happy to see in stores. The Black Light White Rabbit from Alice in Wonderland. So now the set is still complete, including the Funko Sodas. So we have all of them, but this is definitely really nice. I'm excited to have it in my collection. And then we had one huge surprise drop at Funko Hollywood today. It was the limited edition 2000 piece Jack in the Box in the red jumpsuit. Check that out, guys. Limited edition of 2000 pieces. What a great surprise. Now, I definitely would have rather had a lot of the exclusives that they didn't have in stores that I wanted for my collection, but at least they had something cool for us. And then we had one last item in here. You have to spend $100 to get it. It was the Freddy Funko Pop Pin. And then let's go ahead and take it out from here real quick so I can share it. But I'm not gonna open this up just because I have no intention to keep it in my collection. I wanna use it as a trader. But you get one of those four pins on the back. So it's pretty cool for those Freddy Funko fans or the pop pin collectors. I actually lied. I do collect the Pixar pop pins, but that's about it.
So here we have all the pops we're gonna be getting out of the box for a closer look. So let's go ahead and get to the magic in 3, 2, 1. And they're out. Check out all these Funko Pops. They definitely look really great. I'm actually really liking the Fun Days figures. I'm glad I got the entire collection. And I'm really loving the details on today's pickups. They all look really, really cool. And I definitely love the Fanatic Fury. Even the Proto Punks, but they all look really cool. Even the Rangers. I'm surprised by the way they all came out. But my absolute favorite has to be the Rocketeer and the White Rabbit. Let's go ahead and get those 360 spins. So the two packs stayed inside the box because it has tape on it and I did not want to take it off. First up, we've got Torchy, which was part of the Fun Days box. Really cute looking Funko Pop. The finish on it is not the best. You guys can see it has some paint flaws. But overall, it's cool. I wish it glowed. Up next, we have Team Fanatic Fury. Look at this tornado. The details on this figure looks amazing. Absolutely great size. And I just love the way they made this mold. It's definitely the best one out of the four. So I'm not going to lie. This Proto Punks is definitely underrated. What a great looking figure. I love that it has his tattoos. And then on the back side, you can see the crown. And then what's really cool is if you look at this hand right over here, you guys can see that O right on that finger. And then on the front, it says Prot. So it says Proto Punk on his tattoos for his fingers. And then the shirt says Punks. Definitely really great. Up next, we have the second most popular team of the four, Funko Force. Definitely a really cool looking figure, but I still personally think the Proto Punks pop looks a lot better. But this is still a really cool looking figure. And then once again, the least popular of the four teams, we have Pop Rangers. I'm not gonna lie though, this pop does look really cool. I did underrate it, and I do like the design, the stance. Overall, I think this is actually a really nice pop. And then next we have Smaxy the Seal. This is part of the Ad Icons collection. The paint job on it is not the greatest, but I do love my serial Ad Icon pops. So I'm excited to add this one to my collection. Next up, we have another Ad Icon Funko Pop. We've got the Jack in the Box in the red tracksuit. Other than being a limited edition 2000 piece pop, I don't think it's that great. It's not much different than the first one, which I like more. This Rocketeer Funko Pop came out looking fantastic. Look at the details on this figure. Super cool. I love when the Funko Pops are on stands like this. It makes it look so much cooler. I love this pop. And then finally, here we have our Blacklight White Rabbit to complete our Alice in Wonderland Blacklight set. Now, if you guys look closely, there's one that's missing. I have a feeling it's going to be the March Hare. And then there we have the Blacklight White Rabbit with the Blacklight on. It looks really cool. And then the Fanatic Fury Tornado looks pretty cool with the Blacklight on too. So with the use of my Funko Podium, here are my top three favorites from today's video. Number three is going to the Fanatic Fury Tornado. And then number two, we have the Rocketeer. Number one, the Blacklight White Rabbit. But I'm sure this will change once I get my Funko lottery order in.
So that's all I had for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you all for watching. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for future content. Let me know in the comments below if you guys picked up anything from FunCon, whether it was the Fun Days boxes or if you were selected for a lottery, how'd it go? I did miss out on some stuff I wanted, so hopefully tomorrow I could pick those up. And once I get everything, I'll make a video, so stay tuned for that. I just want to say thank you guys so much for taking time every day to watch this video. Let me know what you guys would enjoy seeing in the next ones. Thank you all for watching, and peace.